humans have always worshipped the sun. It brings us light, energy, food, but really, it's trying to kill us. Nowadays, thanks to pseudoscience and the internet's fantastic ability to spread it, all sorts of modern-day snake oil salesmen are trying to cash in on natural, historic remedies. But you never hear of ancient people dying of skin cancer. What was their secret? Well, they died. Back when the life expectancy was 50 years, if you were lucky, people didn't live long enough for the decades it takes for skin cancer to develop.
But our ancestors were smart enough to know the sun was dangerous. If you were rich, you stayed in the shade, while all the poor people did the work in the sun. So, the paler you were, the better. Natural sun-protecting concoctions go back to the ancient Egyptians, who used a mix of rice, lupine, and jasmine to block out Ra's rays. The ancient Greeks tried to stop Helios with olive oil, and the Native Americans used sunflower oil to block out their many, many sun deities. Now, these did not work that well, but probably smelled delicious. The only effective forms of sunblock were wearing long clothes and fantastic hats. So, pale continued to be in vogue, to such extremes in Elizabethan times when they used ceruse made from white lead and vinegar, which not only blocked the sun's rays, but dyed the skin white and gave you lead poisoning. Thanks to the ages of exploration and colonization, white people spread throughout the world to latitudes they were never evolved to be on. Nowhere is that more true than Australia.
Which makes it no surprise that in 1932, a South Australian chemist, Milton Blake, created a sun protective cream after 12 years of experimentation in his kitchen.
4 years later, a chemist named Eugene Schuller, who had also invented hair color and founded L'Oreal, refined Blake's formula, and sunscreen hit the market. Unfortunately, neither of their formulas were that effective. 1944, World War II, Benjamin Green, a pharmacist and airman, used a substance called Red Veterinary Petroleum, or Red Ved Pet, to protect himself and friends from the sun. By 1946, a Swiss chemist named Franz Grieder created Pisbrun Glacier Cream with a whopping SPF of 2. Now, this is credited as the first real modern sunscreen and establishing SPF.
It's complicated and confusing. SPF means the amount of time it takes before the skin burns with the protection, not how long the cream lasts on your skin. An SPF of 70 equals 12 hours of sun protection. Overkill, unless you're in, like, Iceland. But because of sweat and water, it still needs reapplying at least every hour.
Meanwhile, back from the war, Benjamin Green mixed Red Ved Pet with cocoa butter and coconut oil. It is this formula that would ultimately become Coppertone and popularize sunscreen to the masses.
Now rewind to the 1920s.
Pop icon Coco Chanel accidentally falls asleep in the sun on a boat on vacation. Now she embraces her tan, convincing everyone it's fashionable. And the tan is born.
And fast forward to the 1960s.
Now, thanks to the rise of beach culture around this time, baby boomers start to believe that having the money to sit in the sun all day is best. There is nothing healthy about a tan. It's all just hype. Unfortunately, thanks to generations of abuse, the ozone layer started to break down in time for all the new millennial babies. Skin cancer rates shoot through the roof, and scientists started to research into UVA and UVB rays.
UVA rays are responsible for tanning and eventually aging your skin and causing cancer. UVB rays are primarily what burns your skin and causes more cancer.
But even Baz Luhrmann couldn't convince us all in the 90s to
wear sunscreen.
Even as new, better formulas have been released. So remember this, even if your ancestors blessed you with darker skin or the power to tan, thanks to modern medical science, like vaccinations, you'll probably live a lot longer. So the sun's 6 billion year old radioactive rays have plenty of time to damage your skin's DNA, promote cancer, and make you age faster than at the end of Indiana Jones. To stop this, even on cloudy days, wear a full spectrum sunscreen with at least an SPF of 30. And anything after 50, like 70, is not doing enough to justify its higher price tag.
Oh.